This video is entitled, How Did the Student Cross the Road? It's about traffic safety in school zones and how these can be improved. We see here the intersection with the school behind it, and this is how students cross the intersection. The school is on the right. Further down the street, we see the westbound bus stop half block from this intersection. Likewise, here is the view from the intersection and potential bus stop across the school. Basically, the responsibility is to provide safe passage across Lawrence Avenue between the school and the westbound traffic. Shown here in the red squares are the two bus stops, and the outline bus is a potential stop at the light, where they do actually stop from time to time. Therefore, we see a pedestrian circulation network on the north side of the street, and again the square where the intersection is. The orange arrows indicate the shortcuts students take across the street, and there have been several incidents involving personal injury accidents. Likewise, we see here where cars coming off the side street end up in conflict with students crossing the street, and many of these cars are parents dropping students off. Here's the morning condition showing students coming from that north bus stop further across on the far side of the street, bunching at the lights and then crossing. We can see as well, coming from the side street on the left, cars that disperse going east and west along Lawrence Avenue. Closing in, we can see here, students arriving at, crossing at the light, the cars that then end up across their footpath. And further down the street, we actually see where students are taking the shortcut right across the street without bothering to come up to the light. That was the morning situation. Now let's take a look at the afternoon condition. The afternoon condition is much the same, other than the fact that rather than racing for the bell to get to school, students disperse at their leisure, in a sense, away from the school, which distributes the loading somewhat. Again, we see here, as students cross the street, that the cars turning left are actually approaching behind these students, so the students don't see them. They are reliant upon the driver. There is the shortcut being taken. And there again is another, and again we see another shortcut being taken across the street. The solution to this problem is actually to disband the whole west bus stop location, and in so doing, get rid of all the shortcutting that students take across the street. By locating this bus at the lights, where in many cases buses stop anyway, you can then limit the amount of pedestrian footpath to a small area, fully under control of the lights with no shortcuts, and likewise you can tape the intersection to show cars how to come up and proceed on a 90-degree angle so they have the visibility, and likewise they're actually able to use both lanes, which means that more of them get out without feeling the pressure. Also shown here is the ability to actually station buses at the end of the day at the school. So that is how to improve the conditions of this school. In closing, it's of interest to note that in New South Wales, Australia, all 10,000 schools bear this markation of the road with these dragon teeth, indicating to drivers to proceed with caution as they are in the school zone.